So this is where we turned to NuPrl. As I mentioned already, NuPrl is a theoretical framework, and there is a way by which the OCaml code can be converted to NuPrl code. There is a tool that allows the transformation to be done, very simply. We use that tool to convert the unoptimized OCaml code to the NuPrl code. And once you have the NuPrl code, then we can roll up our sleeves and say, how do we go about optimizing this NuPrl code? There are two-step process for this. The first step is what is called static optimization. And this requires that a NuPrl expert and the OCaml expert sit together and in a semi-automatic manner, they go layer by layer in the protocol stack and identify what transformation code can be applied in order to optimize each of the layers. We are not going across layers, but for every layer we are asking the question, is it possible to simplify the functionality of what is happening in one layer by looking at the NuPrl code and using the NuPrl framework and the optimization theorems that is part of that framework to come up with a more optimized implementation of each and every one of these layers. That's what we're doing in this first step. This is where both the NuPrl expert and the OCaml expert have to sit together because you want the NuPrl expert to know whether the optimization that they are attempting to do is kosher with respect to the functionality that is desired in the OCaml code. And that's why this is semi-automatic, because the optimization itself can be done using the theorem-proving framework, but whether that optimization is an appropriate one or not is something that has to be verified with manual intervention. And the kinds of code transformations that can be done are things like function inlining. If you have function calls, then you can make them inline, and that is one way of optimizing it within a layer. And directed equality substitution is another optimization that can be done. There are some things that are very specific to functional programming leading to code simplicity, and all of those things are what is being done in the static optimization of every layer in the protocol stack. Remember, we're not going across layers, but every layer we're doing the static optimization. This is good, but unfortunately that's not enough, because we have lots of layers between a message arriving and the application getting that message, or vice versa. And what we want to be able to do is, if possible, collapse all these layers. Because when we go through these multiple layers, we are adding latency to the overall processing of any message. And this is where we are going to turn to the power of the NuPrl theorem-proving framework. So the next step is dynamic optimization, which is attempting to collapse these multiple layers, and it is completely automatic. The previous one I said layer by layer, we're doing semi-automatic fashion. This is completely automatic, and it is the power of that theorem-proving framework, which is actually going to do that for you. And in order for that theorem-proving framework to do this work, what we need to identify is what are common things that happen in order to do this collapsing of layers.